Chairman and Director, it gives me profound pleasure to be here today with you all to hand over the message to the students, the Nausori Multi Cultural Center. I would like to thank the administrator and the chairman, particularly the chairman, because they are unpaid people. They spend their family time, their personal time, to contribute towards developing of wisdom, cultural, spiritual wisdom in our community, in our country, which is pretty special, given its multi-religious, multi-ethnic dimension. Thank you very much for coming here today. Ladies and gentlemen, our multicultural centers have various cultural programs in place. Through its program, the centers assist in providing avenues for extracurricular activities for young people and communities, help sustain the culture of the ethnic groups in PD, promote cultural values, ideas and communities through cross-cultural initiatives, and provide opportunities for unemployed youths and women through income-generating activities organized through their classes. The main motive of Nausori Center is to promote art and culture to the residents who live in the vicinity of Nausori and nearby areas, regardless of their ethnic and religious beliefs. This is the very place where cultural exchange takes place at its best. The beautiful aspect of the center is that it is able to reach out to the community, educate them, and train them in different forms of art. Ladies and gentlemen, culture is the blessing that every individual is associated with through their daily lives. We are all governed through the norms and regulations of our society, and culture is an integral part of it. In addition, survival of culture amidst today's ever-changing and transformational global society is not only necessary, but also a key element vital to the survival of humans. Our culture is our identity, and I am proud that this institution sees the protection of this identity and promotion of our key cultural aspects as a priority. We are blessed and fortunate that we are allowed to grow in a multicultural and multi-religious environment. Our Honourable Prime Minister oversees a united region where people share their cultural aspects, appreciate each other's unique skills and diversities, and be an example of harmony to the rest of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, our education system is geared towards developing our children for future peace, for nation building. We are indeed blessed to be here, to grow in this country amongst different ethnic groups, different people with different religious beliefs. It makes us better, rounded citizens. And it is for this reason that through our education system, we are giving out now write-ups on the various religious holidays, what it means. So we are sending to our schools, say, for example, in Ram Navami or Holi or Easter, we set up a two-page writer, of course, vetted by the relevant faith-based group, which we want the head teachers or principals to read out to the children, and the children to take a copy, so that they know about this particular religious day. It is not about converting them, but we want them to know what is Easter, what does Ram Navami message, what is Ram Navami message, what is Holi message. We began it this year, because that's what education is about. In our school system, if we don't do that, then we will fail to deliver well-developed, holistically developed child for future teaching. In addition to using the formal institution of schools, we are now also empowering our children through our cultural centers to take part in activities which will upskill them with certain cultural aspects, skills, arts, which will get them to develop themselves as a holistic child for future teaching. So ladies and gentlemen, as I had said in Lambasa, at one of the cultural center events, that for any economy, for the economy to grow, we need transactions to take place, people to exchange. for one person to engage into transaction with another person or an institution, people need to trust each other. Without trust, there won't be any transaction. For example, a farmer has a goat, and Sheikh Al-Taf goes to the farmer and gives $200 to buy the goat. For the farmer to part with the goat, the farmer has to trust the $200 bills and trust that he is giving a original $100 note, and trust that the institutions, financial institutions in Fiji, values the $100 bill. Similarly, when you go to the shop to buy groceries, when you give some notes, the shopkeeper will give you sharp or sugar or tin fish, etc. That's a particular good, consumable. But the paper, pieces of paper, is not consumed. So the shopkeeper has to trust. Now the trust, the moment in any country, it has happened. Argentina once. The moment the trust breaks down, no one will exchange. No one will engage in exchange. The moment transactions don't take place, no exchange is happening, the economy collapses. Now for trust to be there in any country, any community, any society, social capital needs to be there. And social capital is built by values, virtues, education, cultural education. It is the strong culture, the strong social fabric of this society that is keeping us together as Fijians. This Fiji today, we are all united because of our social fabric. And the social fabric, the social capital, we've got financial capital, we've got physical capital, we've got natural capital. But for our country to have wisdom, to have peace, stability and harmony, we need strong social capital foundation. For social capital foundation, we need values, virtues, religious, cultural education. And these institutions that we are now nurturing, the cultural centers, the temples and mosques and masjids, and the informal institutions like mandalis and youth groups, all these contribute towards building of social capital, social cohesion. With that, communities grow together. In communities, people are different, with different social background. So with social capital, these communities group together, different groupings, and they group together. It is important that we foster, support this institution so that social capital grows, communities get together, get united, and they grow together. This is the kind of growth model that will contribute towards a future Fiji, which has peace, prosperity and stability. We don't want a banyan tree growth model. And if you have seen a banyan tree in Pakalpur, when a banyan tree grows, nothing around the banyan tree can grow. We don't believe in the banyan tree growth model. We believe, our Honorable Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, believes that everyone in this country deserves to be given an opportunity to grow together, immaterial of what ethnicity they belong to, what religious belief they hold, or where they originate from, whether they come from Udu Point or Squatter Settlement or Kandavu Asawa. Everyone has the right to access education. Everyone has the right to access water, electricity, good infrastructure. That is the development paradigm of this government. Everyone needs to grow together. Everyone has the right to grow together. Everyone has the right to access education, quality education, education which will transform societies, households and countries towards peace, progress, stability and prosperity. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure today to join our staff here, the director. We hand over the various instruments to you all. I do hope and request that this is utilized to develop and create our own identity as Fijians. We're not Indians, we are Fijians. We should help develop our own identity using music, fusion songs, fusion dance items, develop our own original songs, original items that will depict us as Fijians.